Bavinck says that while the scripture necessarily speaks in anthropomorphic language, which is your point, he says at the same time, that language prohibits us from ascribing any change to God. And he says there's change around, about, and outside. There's change in people's relation to him, but there's no change in God himself. Why? Here's the key. There is nothing intermediate between these two classes of categories. There is the self-contained creator, and there is the creature, and there is no intermediate third thing, some third kind of property that's neither God nor the creature. There's no third thing that relates the two. And so the mystery of this relationship, the majestic and mysterious dimension of the relationship, Bavinck put so well, and this is, I think this is could be a commentary on Isaiah 57:15, is this: without losing himself, either his essence or the persons, immutable, impassible persons, God can give himself. I'll say that again without my amplification. Without losing himself, God can give himself, and while absolutely maintaining his immutability, he can enter into an infinite number of relations to creatures.
That's a quote.
That's a quote from Bavinck, RD 2, 158 through 59. And Camden, isn't that a beautiful summary of the Lord who is and remains the one who is high and lifted up, who dwells in the high and holy place, and who is also at the same time sovereignly related to the one who is contrite and lowly in spirit, namely related to the creature? It's a beautiful way of capturing it. And I think the takeaway for us is that the anthropomorphic language, far from sanctioning the mutability of God, is actually prohibitive of ascribing mutability to God, yet at the same time reminds us that when God gives himself, he does not lose himself in the giving, but remains who he is.